Crash Bandicoot is hopping onto some new platforms. Sonic the Hedgehog is such a tease. And the producer behind Battlestar Galactica and Outlander has a huge new deal with Disney. All that and the latest and everything cool today in The Rundown. Hey, welcome to the show, everybody. We're going to have some fun today, and this show is dedicated to our buddy, Mr. Brockerock, who says that he hopes the Callisto Protocol has as much gameplay innovation as Dead Space did. I think we can count on that, buddy. All right, let's get started with some news on the world's most famous Bandicoot. Man, I've always loved me some action-adventure platformers, and Crash Bandicoot 4, It's About Time, was a terrific experience last year. It was one of the most enjoyable games that I played. Developed by Toys for Bob, it came out for the PlayStation 4 and the Xbox One, but now it's headed to the Xbox Series platforms, the X and the S, as well as the PlayStation 5. It's also coming to Battle.net for the PC, and we all knew this was happening. It's also going to be coming out for the Nintendo Switch, and there's going to be a bunch of next-gen features that are going to make the game sing a little bit more if you play it on PlayStation 5 or the Xbox Series X. It's going to run at 4K 60 frames per second. The PlayStation 5 version of the game is going to take full advantage of the DualSense controller, so you're going to feel some of that haptic feedback as you're playing through the game and playing as all of these cool different characters. The Nintendo Switch version, obviously, you can carry it on the go, and I'm sure the PC version can ramp up to some beautiful specs as well. What's really cool about this is that if you've already purchased this game on the Xbox platform or the PlayStation platform, you get the upgrades for no extra cost when you go into next gen. And the next gen versions are a little bit pricier than picking it up on PC or Switch. So you may want to take a look around at sales for the PlayStation 4 or the Xbox One version of this game before you jump in, because it's going to cost you a little bit more if you pay for the full price for a PS5 or Xbox Series version of this title. So keep that in mind. The game was a ton of fun. It's incredibly challenging. One of the cool features with the PlayStation 5 card feature, the way they kind of have all of these different pieces of information that pop up as you're playing through games, is maybe you're going to be able to get some helpful hints, and you may need them. It's challenging, and I was swearing a lot when I was playing it, and man, it was beautiful last year, but I can't wait to see this run with all of the flash and all of the sizzle sort of cranked up to 11. Crash Bandicoot 4, It's About Time is coming out next month, and I'm definitely going to be taking a look at that again. I've also asked for Nintendo Switch code for the game, so I'll report back with some thoughts on how it handles on Nintendo's platform. Looking forward to jumping back in next month. Now, we've got much more than a month to wait for this gorgeous new game that just dropped some new footage in honor of Chinese New Year. Black Myth Wukong is a new game being developed by Game Science, a Chinese independent developer, and this title's coming out for the PlayStation 5 and the Xbox Series platforms and Windows PCs in 2023. So they've got a lot of work to do. Last year, they showed us a 13-minute demo of some of the gameplay in it. It's designed to be a Souls-like with some beautiful martial arts mechanics, unbelievably cool animation. You can see all kinds of great details on the characters and these mythological beasts and creations that populate this game. It looks like it's going to be loaded with unbelievable lighting and dust particles and just intense, gorgeous details. Now, what they've shown off in this celebratory video to honor Chinese New Year is not meant to be plot-focused. It's just a celebration of some of the mythical creatures, I think, that are in the game. But even this is jaw-dropping. Gorgeous boss fights, lots of chaos on screen, lots of flourish, lots of, you know, magic attacks, and it just looks so intense and so gorgeous. This is meant to be a full-price game. It's not going to be like some kind of a subscription thing, and there might be some DLC, but yes, we've got a lot more to learn about this title and a long time to wait, but 2023 can't come fast enough, and man, it's going to be really cool. Like, we're still in this stage right now where we're dealing with a lot of cross-gen, and, you know, like with Crash Bandicoot 4 coming to the PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series platform, that's great, but it's going to be amazing to see this full-on transformation to what this new generation is fully capable of. I think we're getting a hint of that with some of the PC stuff, but still, a lot of the PC things, even the top-end PC things, also have to run on PS4 and Xbox One. And those are great platforms, but it's going to be incredible to kind of leap forward, and I think Black Myth Wukong kind of shows us a glimpse of what that future is going to look like. Now, over in the world of television, one of my favorite executive producers and TV creators has just done a huge deal with Disney. Ronald D. Moore is the executive producer and showrunner that brought back Battlestar Galactica for the Sci-Fi Channel and blew our collective minds back in the early 2000s. He then went on to adapt the Outlander books into a fantastic TV series with Sony Television, and that has been a phenomenal success. Most recently, he has kickstarted the For All Mankind series on Apple TV Plus, which is actually great. The second season of that show is coming up soon, and you need to check out the trailer. It is absolutely riveting. Very much looking forward to catching up with For All Mankind Season 2 very soon. Can't wait to see that. And that was also developed with Sony, but he has since left Sony Television and now has done a huge deal with 20th Century Television, which is owned by Disney. So he's going to be brought under the Disney umbrella. And the first project that he's going to be creating for Disney / 20th Century Television is a reboot of Swiss Family Robinson. And this could be amazing. I don't know if it's going to be sci-fi tinged. A lot of his work is definitely sci-fi tinged. He has, you know, roots in history and Star Trek. Battlestar Galactica is just an extraordinary work of television. If you've never caught that series, I'm envious of you. You need to watch it. And Outlander is one of our family's favorite new addictions. It's an incredible series that has all kinds of amazing twists and turns, so catch that if you can. So I'm really excited to find out where this is going to go with Disney, because Swiss Family Robinson is only going to be the first of many kinds of ideas that are going to bubble up from Ronald D. Moore through Disney's ranks there. And believe me, Disney is incredibly excited to have Ronald D. Moore be a part of their roster, their creative roster. The head of 20th TV's Carolyn Cassidy had this to say: Ron's as passionate about Disney parks, characters, and IP as our head of drama, Michelle Mendolovitz, was about bringing him to the studio. And when he said yes, we were all thrilled beyond belief. His beautiful work on Battlestar Galactica, Outlander, and For All Mankind are well known for their artistry and intelligence, their unforgettable characters, and big broad appeal, and it's been so exciting for Carrie, Michelle, and me to see how inspired he is by the Disney canon. Swiss Family Robinson is just the first project he has up his sleeve, and we're so glad he's made 20th his creative home. This is incredible stuff, because there was a time when Ronald D. Moore was going to work with George Lucas on a Star Wars television show, and clearly Star Wars on TV is a big deal. He's got to make an awesome sort of first showing here with Swiss Family Robinson, and this is a property that's been important to Disney for many years, so it will be cool to see his take on that. But the guy lives in the world of sci-fi, and Disney owns Star Wars and all of these incredible Marvel characters as well. This is going to lead to some amazing things, really amazing things. So that's exciting news if you're a fan of great TV. And if you're not familiar with Ronald D. Moore's work, you've got some great catching up to do. And finally, the fine folks at Paramount Pictures and Sega have given us a little tease of when we're going to see Sonic the Hedgehog and apparently Tails in his new movie. It's April 8th, 2022. We've got a little bit of a wait, but man, I freaking adore that first movie. I just rewatched my review of the Sonic the Hedgehog movie from last year, and I was just a giddy little boy. And I was outside. It was weird. That was like one of the last movies I went to the theater to see. And I had such a great time with that movie. I adored that movie. And I was just so overjoyed to see all of the creative intelligence and the real love for the property that was put into the first Sonic the Hedgehog movie. Now the stakes are very high. It was a huge financial success. It was a creative success. Everybody that loves Sega and loves this character, I think, was very happy with the first film. So let's see if they can knock it out of the park again with the sequel. Comes out April 8th, 2022. Mark it on your calendars. All right, you guys, that's going to do it for our rundown today. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be back again tomorrow with a brand new episode. Thank you to all of our subscribers out there, our longtime subscribers and our brand new ones. I see you. Thank you. And of course, to all of our wonderful EPN members, you guys rock. We'll see you tomorrow. And until then, play forever.